panic selling. The flash crash of May 6, 2010. The Dow plunges nearly 10% in less than 30 minutes. The panic leading to a suspension of logic.
Rationally, it was clear that something was amiss, something was going on.
That the human brain really does not like surprise. The reason the flash crash was so devastating is because it was so inexplicable. It caught people completely by surprise.
If you choose the gamble, you have a 50-50 shot of keeping all 40 or losing all, so you'd receive zero.
Okay.
It's this type of risk and reward scenario that neuroscientists like Scott Hattell and the team at Duke University hope to better understand by conducting experiments with real money. This is called a functional MRI. And what does it have to do with how we save our money, how we spend our money, how we risk our money? Everything, because it shows what's happening right up here. In the MRI, volunteers are presented with different choices. Keep a small amount or risk it to win more. By changing the dollar amounts at risk and the dollar amounts that can be gained, scientists are able to see how different areas of the brain react as decisions are made.
There's an area that we're very interested in. It's called dorsomedial prefrontal cortex. That's a fancy way of saying the area that's in the middle, top, and front of your brain. And that part of the brain seems to act as almost like a switch in a train yard, where it's telling all the other parts of the brain that might contribute to a decision which ones are going to be active at any moment in time. And so what it does is it seems to switch between, say, a more risk-averse and a risk-seeking mode, depending on what's going on in the task at any moment in time.
140 and 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And that's your payment for today.
Thank you.
That was a great winning.
So imaging technology can tell you a lot about what your brain is doing, how you're thinking and feeling about spending your money. That's pretty high tech. There's also a pretty low tech way. When the person goes in the MRI, they're giving you a saliva sample, and the saliva is going into something like this.
That's just a
tube like this holding their saliva. What?
A simple tube.
What do they find? What do you find in this simple tube? What does it tell you about what somebody's brain is thinking or doing about money or risk?
Well, so the way that we use this is we take individual saliva samples, and through a test that's been available for the last 40 years, we can measure things like aspects of their DNA. We can measure hormones like testosterone or the stress hormone cortisol. And so through the MRI, we can look at interactions between your physiology, so something like testosterone or cortisol, and your brain activity when you're processing some of the gambles that we have people do in the scanner.
Interesting. So it's not just the picture of the brain, it's the picture of the brain you're taking and what you're finding in the saliva, the hormones and other things that are taking the entire picture of what somebody is doing financially with the risk and reward.
That's right. Because really, the thing that we're growing to understand in these interdisciplinary fields, something like neuroeconomics, where you're combining the field of neuroscience and behavioral economics, is that our decisions are influenced at multiple levels. So we can try to study behavior by itself, we can try to study the brain by itself, but the more you account for all aspects of both behavior and physiology and neuroscience, I think that that's going to continue to let us, more completely understand our behavior.
Christine Romans, Durham, North Carolina.